some great information for finding the international class, which should not be overlooked, is in USPTO.gov. And if you go over to the search box on the top right and type in NICE agreement, and yes, it should be pronounced NICE agreement, and click return, you get a result here, NICE agreement 10th edition. Click that link. This page here, you should definitely bookmark. This has just some great information. Up at the top here, it describes some general information about goods and then some general information about services. But what I really like in this class headings and explanatory notes is a section here where it starts to say, this class includes in particular, and then it gives several examples. But what's really great is it says, this class does not include in particular, and it gives several examples. And this can help keep you on course to making sure that you get the right international class code. Let's go down to class 39 for our example that we've been using for trucking. And just go ahead and double check it. Right at the very top, the header almost, it says transport, packaging and storage of goods, travel arrangement.
And you can read the explanatory note. It can further help you decide if you're in the right international class code when searching for the availability of your word mark or trademark.